Let us see Boolean expressions. Boolean literals, true and false. Only two Boolean literals, true and false. Both are keywords. You should not specify under double quotes. If you specify under double quotes, then both will be considered as a string. You should not specify under double quotes or under single quote. Both are keywords. Straight away try to print. Let us compile and run. True and false. Come to the B class. Not true means false. Not true means false. Not false means true. Because of only two Boolean literals are there. Not true means false. Not false means true. Let us compile and run. Come to the next one. Boolean B1. B1 is a variable name of Boolean type with the initial value true. B1 is a true. Not B1 is a false. Again, B1 is a true. In the second SOP, not B1 is a false, but B1 not modifying to false. B1 remains a true only. We are trying to print other than B1 value, that is false. But B1 remains true, you will be getting a true itself. So the output will be true, then false, then again true. B1 remains true only. Let me clear the console. C.java. Try to run C. You can see true, false, true. Let's move to the next one. See, B1 is a false. B2 is other than B1, that is true. Come on. B1 is a false. B2 is other than B1 value, that is true. If you go for B1, you will get a false. If you go for other than B1, you will get a true. B1 remains false only. B2 remains true only. Not B2 means true, sorry, not B2 means false, then B2 means true. B2 means true. Let us compile and run. You can see. Come to the next one. B1 is equal to true. Straight away printing B1. Then B1 modifying to false. Then modified B1 sending to println. B1 itself modifying to false. Then modified B1 sending to println. False will be printing. False will be printing. B1 also becoming false. you will be getting a false here. Then the next SOP, B1 assigning with true, B1 assigning with true, B1 is equal to not B1, that is not false means true. True is assigning to B1. True only printing over here. True only printing. In the next two also, true only printing. We can modify variable value while printing. We can modify variable value while printing. Let's see. Come to the next one. B1 is not initialized. B1 is not initialized. You cannot use B1 for the printing purpose. Local variable should be initialized before usage. Local variable should be initialized before usage. It is not initialized. You will be getting compilation error. All local variables should be initialized before usage. Come to the G class. We can initialize the variable while using also. We can initialize the variable while using also. Here first B1 is equal to true will be executing. Then B1 will be sending to println. By the time of sending B1 to the println, B1 got a value, that is a true. While using a variable, you can initialize it. This will be compiling very successfully. You will be getting a true. Compilation is very successful. Running also very successful. Come to the H class. Two booleans can be combined to get a result. There are two combining operators. One is a OR, other is a AND. In case of OR, if any one is a true, either left operand or right operand, if any one is a true, then the whole will be resulting in true. So line number 5 is a true, line number 6 also true, line number 8 also true, only line number 7 is a false. The combination of two booleans with a OR as a separator. If any one is a true, then it will be true. If any one is a true, true or true results in true, true or false result in true. False or true results in true. False or false, it is a false. Combining multiple booleans with a OR symbol. True true, false true. Come to the next one. Combining with the AND. In case of AND, if both are true, then only result will be true. If both are true, then only result can be true. So first one only true here. First one is a true. Second one is false, third one is a false, fourth one also false. If any one is a false, the result will be false while combining with AND operator. In case of AND, both operands, left side operand, right side operand, if both operands are true, then only combination will be true. This is true. Second one is a false, third one is a false, fourth one also false. Can see. Come to the next one. Initially, x is 0. Then, x is becoming 1, but 0 only applying. X is becoming 1, but 0 only applying. 0 comparing with 0, it results a true. B1 will be assigning with a true. B1 will be assigning with a true. X will be 1. By the time of printing X, 1 will be affecting. But in the Boolean expression, 0 only affecting because of post increment. Even though X is becoming 1, 0 only applying. 0 double equal to 0 is a true. B1 assigning with a true, B1 is a true. But X while printing, it will be 1. The output will be 1 and true. Come to the next one. K class, x is equal to 0, b1 is equal to, what is happening here, x is becoming 1, x is becoming 1, 1 is comparing with 0, 1 only using here because of 3, 1 only using, 1 is comparing with 0, while 1 is comparing with 0, you will be getting a false. B1 will be false, X will be 1. 1 and false. 1 and false. Come to the next one. So here, while combining with R, if first operand is a true, then second one will not be executing because of first one is a true. No matter what is a second one, this complete portion, whatever portion I selected, this will not be executing. Why? Because first one is a true. No matter whether second one is a true or false, B1 will be assigning with a true. In case of R combining, if first one is a true, second one will not be processing. In case of R combining, if first one is a true, then second one will not be processing. This selected one is not processed. Because of that, I is not incremented to 1. I is not incremented to 1. I remains 0 only. If this is executed, I would have become a 1. While printing SOP of I at line number 7, you will be getting 0 only. You are getting a 0 and true. Let's compile. I repeat one more time, please observe, in case of R combining, if first one is a true, second one doesn't require to process. In case of R combining, if first one is a true, then second one doesn't require to classes. This completely skippable. Whatever portion I selected, it is not executed, doesn't require to execute, it is not influencing final value of B1. B1 will be true even though the selected one resulting a false. Even though the selected one is resulting a false, B1 will be true only. That is why, while combining with R, if first operand is a true, then second operand will not be executing. Second operand will not be executing. Because of second operand not executed, I remains 0. I is not becoming 1. Come to the M. Now, we are combining with R symbol. First operand is a false. If first operand is a false, then definitely it will be processing second one. It checks whether at least second one is returning a true to get B1 value as a true. Now it cannot take a decision through first operand false. It has to process the second operand. While processing second operand, I is becoming 1, but 0 only applying. While comparing 0 with 0, you will be getting a true. Not only I is becoming 1, the second operand resulting a true. So B1 is equal to false or true. If it is a false or true, then B1 value will be true. B1 value will be true. So I value 1, B1 value 2. Why I value 1? Second operand executed. Why it is executed? First operand is a false. If first operand is a false, in case of R, second one will be executing. Because of it is executing, I became a 1. Can see. Come to the N class. In case of AND combining, if first operand is a false, it won't execute the second one. Why? Because even though second one is resulting a true, B1 will result a false only. If first one is a false, no matter whether second one is a true or false, result will be false. While combining with AND, if first operand is a false, it won't execute second operand. The selected portion not executed, B1 assigned with false blindly. B1 assigned with a false blindly. Mom. This I value remains 0. It is gone. This is very important. While combining two booleans with AND. While combining two booleans with AND. If first boolean is a false, second one will not be processing. Doesn't required. If first one is a false, second one won't execute. Second one is not processing. If second one is not processed, I will be remains 0, I will not be becoming 1. So that is why 0 and false. 0 and false. Come to the O. So please observe. Because our first one is a true, then definitely it has to take a suggestion of second operand. If second operand also true, then B1 will be true. First one is a true. Now, it is a time to execute second one. Because of first one is a true, If second one also true, then B1 will be resulting in true. So second operand executing. Second operand executing. While executing second operand, I is becoming 1, but applying value 0. While 0 is applying and comparing with another 0, you will be getting a true. B1 is equal to true and true. B1 is equal to true and true. But I became a 1. You will be getting 1 and true. 1 and true. One and two.